than 50 years we have struggled under the burden and rigors of slavery. We were maimed, we were brutalized, we were ravaged in every way. We are men. We have hopes, we have passions, we have feelings, we have desires just like any other race. The cry is raised all over the world of Canada for the Canadians, of America for the Americans, of England for the English, of France for the French, of Germany for the Germans. Do you think it unreasonable that we, the blacks of the world, should raise the cry of Africa for the Africans? The Negro is a man. We represent a new Negro. His back is not yet against the wall. We do not want his back against the wall because that would be a peculiar and desperate position. We do not want him there. It is because of this that we are asking for fair compromise. Where the Belgians have control of the Belgian Congo, which they cannot use, they have not the resources to develop, nor the intelligence. The French have more territory than they can develop. There are certain parts of Africa in which they cannot live at all. So it is for you to come together and give us a United States of Africa.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We are not going to be a race without a country. God never intended it, and we are not going to be God's confidence in us as men. We are men, human beings, capable of the same acts as any other race, possessing under fair circumstances the same intelligence as any other race. Now Africa's been sleeping, not dead, only sleeping. Today Africa's walking around not only on our feet, but on our brains. You can enslave us, was done for 300 years, the bodies of men. You can shackle the hands of men. You can shackle the feet of men. You can imprison the bodies of men, but you cannot shackle or imprison the minds of men. Dive down, black men, and dig. Reach up, black men and women, and pull all nature's knowledge to you. Turn ye around and make a conquest of everything, north and south, east and west. And then when you have wrought well, you will have merited God's blessing. You will have become God's chosen people, and naturally you'll become leaders of the world. And as you bow down to the white man today, so will other races bow down to you and call your race a master because of the superiority of your mind and your achievement. Because no race has the last word on culture and on civilization. They do not know what we are capable of. They do not know what we are thinking. They're thinking in terms of dreadnoughts, battleships, aeroplanes, submarines. You know what we're thinking about? That is our own private business. So give us credit for being able to use our minds. And with people becoming conscious of themselves, determined to use their minds, you do not know to what extent they can go. Liberate the minds of men, and ultimately you will liberate the bodies of men.